Hello, my name is Cindy Matsen. I am a breast cancer surgeon at Huntsman Cancer Institute at the University of Utah. In this video, I will be discussing surgical options for breast cancer. Almost all patients with breast cancer that has not spread to other parts of their body will have surgery as part of their treatment. Sometimes surgery is the first phase of treatment. Sometimes we do surgery after chemotherapy. You and your surgeon will discuss your specific situation when you come for your appointment. Your surgeon will let you know what your cancer care team recommends for you. Whether or not you get chemotherapy is not based on the kind of surgery you have. The decision for chemotherapy is based on the type of cancer you have and how far it has spread. It has nothing to do with the kind of surgery you choose. Surgery for breast cancer is done to remove the disease and to get more information about your cancer. There is no right or wrong choice. Every woman feels differently about her breast. My goal is to give you enough information that you choose the best option for you. For many women, there are two options for breast cancer surgery. Mastectomy removes the entire breast. Breast conservation, also called lumpectomy followed by radiation, removes the tissue where the cancer is and leaves the rest of the breast. As I said, lumpectomy is almost always followed by radiation. Not every woman has a choice, but the majority do. You and your surgeon will discuss your specific situation when you come in for your appointment. Many women think it seems odd that there is a choice. Shouldn't there be simply one best way to treat breast cancer? But we know from data going back many decades that the chance you will live a long time after your cancer, also called survival, is the same with either procedure. Survival is the thing we care about most, but there are other considerations and differences between the two surgeries. Let's go over some of those now. Mastectomy removes the entire breast. There are reconstruction options to recreate a breast shape. It is a bigger surgery, and you will stay in the hospital, usually for just one night. You will have drains in place after surgery, and these typically stay in for 1 to 2 weeks. Lumpectomy removes the tumor and a rim of normal tissue around it. There will be a scar on your breast, and there may be some change in the shape of your breast. This is an outpatient surgery, so you come in and go home the same day. Most women do not need drains after lumpectomy. There is a chance you will need a second surgery if there are microscopic cancer cells at the edges of the tissue, which are called the margins. This happens with about 15 in 100 lumpectomy surgeries. This type of surgery is almost always followed by radiation, which kills any cancer cells that might remain in your breast. The remaining difference between the two is what we call the risk of recurrence, or the chance that the cancer will come back in your breast or chest wall. The exact numbers for this vary by study, but everyone agrees that the chances are low with either option as long as you get all the treatments you need. What I tell my patients is that about 1-3% of women who have a mastectomy will have cancer come back in their chest wall at 10 to 15 years after surgery. With lumpectomy followed by radiation, the chance that the cancer will come back in the breast is about 5-7% at 10 to 15 years after surgery, which is also low. These numbers are generalities based on large populations of women. They may not apply to your specific case. The medications that are recommended and radiation will also play a role in how likely it is that the cancer will come back. It should be noted that these numbers are the lowest possible estimates that are based on a very favorable breast cancer. You should know that the risk of recurrence depends much more on the stage and type of cancer that you have than the type of surgery that you have, and that in either case, there's a small chance that the cancer can come back. Surgery for breast cancer often includes surgery for the lymph nodes under your arm as well. This is also called your axilla. We remove lymph nodes from under your arm so that we can look at them under the microscope. We need to know if there are cancer cells in the lymph nodes to know what other treatments you might need. Some women only need a few nodes removed with what's called a sentinel lymph node biopsy. Some women need all of the lymph nodes removed, which is called an axillary dissection. Let's talk briefly about how that decision is made. If your surgeon can't feel any abnormal nodes on your physical exam, he or she will perform a sentinel lymph node biopsy during your breast cancer surgery. The sentinel lymph nodes are the first lymph nodes that drain the part of your breast where the cancer is located. To identify these nodes, a radioactive tracer and a blue dye are injected into your breast on the day of surgery. These travel through the drainage system of your breast, which is called the lymphatics, to those very first nodes. Your surgeon can see the nodes that took up the tracer in the operating room and remove them. the pathologist looks at them under the microscope. If they show no or very few cancer cells, the surgeon won't take out any more lymph nodes. Every woman has a different number of sentinel nodes. It has nothing to do with the cancer, it has to do with individual anatomy. The average number of nodes removed is 2. Some women need to have all the lymph nodes under the arm removed, and this is called an axillary dissection. Women who need all of the lymph nodes removed include those who have abnormal nodes on physical exam, women who are getting a mastectomy and have cancer in any sentinel lymph nodes, and women who are getting a lumpectomy with radiation who have cancer in more than 2 sentinel lymph nodes. We know from an important trial published several years ago that if a woman is getting lumpectomy with radiation and has cancer in 2 or fewer lymph nodes, that is a very little bit of cancer, then leaving the other lymph nodes behind is not dangerous even if they contain some cancer cells, because the radiation and other medications will help take care of it. Since most women who get mastectomy don't get radiation, we currently don't know if it is safe to leave some cancer behind with this procedure. Your surgeon will talk with you about your specific needs. The reason we want to remove fewer nodes if possible is because there is a difference in the chances of developing lymphedema or arm swelling after surgery. About 5% of women who have a sentinel lymph node biopsy get lymphedema, and about 15 to 20% of women who have an axillary dissection get it. Again, these are estimates, and different studies report slightly different results. There are many other things women consider when choosing what type of surgery to have, including reconstruction options, mastectomy for the other breast, which is called a contralateral prophylactic mastectomy, and nipple-sparing options. Some of these topics are quite controversial. We can discuss all of these options when you come in for your appointment, and we look forward to seeing you.